shocked, and you guys are going to be so shocked to know that people actually gave me a birthday shout out.
But you should have known it. I wasn't going.
Morning! January 2nd, first day out the door. As you can see, she's healed, honey. And she has a little paint on and she is feeling the flavor. Welcome to this vlog. My name is Brandy and this is my trans life. If you're new here, please do not forget to subscribe. And feel free to binge on the videos that you see, honey. I spent a lot of time working on them. I got some feedback from you guys about my quality being updated. And I'm like, I did everything that I could. And I was like working on it. And I was like, you know what? This quality has to get together. And thank you to the subscriber who let me know in the last video that it was updated. Success and progress for me. So happy about that, guys. I'm putting my all into this, so it's good to know that things are working. We are running late, so we must get out the door. But what we're not doing in 2024 is stressing out about things like being late. We're not carrying that baggage, honey. You know, when I first moved to New York, girl, people would come to work late all the time, and I could not understand, like, why? And they would just be walking in like nothing, as if like, oh, I'm late, it is what it is kind of situation. And I could not wrap my brain around that because, like, being a Capricorn, I'm always punctual. I'm like early. I'm the person that's, let me fix this just a little bit. Oh, perfect. Being a Capricorn, I'm the person that's always early. So I don't know, like, even when I'm late and there's no consequence, I still just feel really bad. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm not respecting people's time or whatever the case may be. So I just could not understand why these people were just walking in late and as if they were just so blasé about it. Well, girl, now I know. Now I know, because there's nothing you can do about it in New York. Like, it just is the way that it is. Commuting is crazy. It takes a long time. There's changes in the routes. There's train traffic every day. I don't care if you leave an hour early, you still might be late. You might do everything in your control and you still might be late, and there's nothing you can do about it. So I'm really grateful for that lesson too, because that's a life lesson now. Like, it's out of my control. I don't need to be stressing and worried about something that I can't control. I can't do it. So in 24, it's none of that. So I am late. We're still going to give it some effort and try to get there, but honey, we're late. So anyway, and I'm not going to, like, this con, like, I got to start my vlog, honey. Like, this is it, so I'll get there. We're going to finish this look off using the Tom Ford Lip Blush. This is one of my favorite things, by the way. So it's just a clear stick with, like, gold in it, but what it does is it matches with your pH and it brings out a color. So let me show you. So put that on and it's clear, you see. Good. Woo. Can you see? A little red, a little blush. So, and then we're gonna top that off with the Dior lip oil that I got the other day, which I love. Well, today I'll wear it for the full day, so I'll know if I love it. But what I do love is this wand. This wand is so fancy and it's soft, so. Love that so much. There we go. And that's the combo for today. Tom Ford Lip Blush, Dior Lip Oil. Has to be a win. I think I told you guys, I tried the Laneige lip mask. I don't like it. I don't like anything about it. I feel like it's drying, actually. So I'm one of those people who, I love lip moisturizer. I have really full lips. You know, look at the color. Sick. So my favorite thing is the cocoa butter stick for lips. Really iconic. And Aquaphor. I like my lips to be rehydrated overnight. Not like just shiny. I feel like the Laneige lip mask, it's not a mask. It's just a shiny lip balm, and it's actually sticky. And I feel like it pulls moisture from your lips. So the next day, my lips are dry. And if I don't have anything on them, they get crusty and dark. I don't like that. So the Laneige lip mask is a no for me. I don't understand why it's so popular. I guess it's just me. Everyone's different, but I don't like it. So anyway, we gotta run, honey. Let's get out into those streets.
Okay, so we made it. I am about 20 minutes late so far and still about 3 minutes to walk. Again, all good, 2024. We are not going to take that on in that way. But Miss Girl, when I tell you, absolutely freezing out here. I think this is the really, like, the first day that it feels this cold. And that's the thing about the weather lately. It goes, hold on. So that's the thing about the weather lately. It goes so warm so much throughout the winter. I think it's been like 50, 60 degrees on a day to day. And then when it gets like this, oh, I was not ready. Look at my shoes. Like, I was not ready. I feel like it's even gotten colder since I walked the dogs. These are the shoes that I have on. My little feet. Pray for my feet. Frigid. Okay, we're going to work. See you guys in a bit. All right, so I finally made it into the warm, but I am not vlogging right now, but I wanted to get under this light and show you guys. Look at this skin, honey. This is all from VIPO. I mean, yes, I have makeup on, but my God, did it clear me up. Oh, tell me what you think in the comments. I'm here early because I have to do an end of the year inventory, and I was like, they were like, you can do it on the 31st. I was like, no ma'am, I will be home safe on the 31st, but I will do it on the 2nd. So I'm here doing inventory, and we're quite low on everything. So let me get to it before people come in. Here's my coffee. Look how good I look. Oh, gagging at this. Wow. Okay, cheers. Eating lunch, Whole Foods, some sort of barbecue chicken, mac and cheese, which is too milky, so I won't eat that, and then potatoes. It's the new year. I'm going into the gym, so I'm gonna have a fat meal right now. And it's so good. Guys, I got a really amazing email today. I am so freaking excited. I'm not gonna tell you guys what it is right now because I have to send in some documentation and stuff. What in the world is happening? January 2nd, I told you guys, like, this is the year. January 2nd's here today. I get an email this morning. I woke up this morning, like, 4:30, 5 o'clock, whatever, laying in bed on my phone. I was like, usually I would say, let me try to squeeze in as much sleep as I can before my alarm goes off. Not today. Today I said, no, I'm going to get up. So I rolled over, I got up, and I just took this day by storm, you know, like, I stepped into this day saying that this is a new year, this is a new day, and my mentality needs to be, I need to be there. There are no, like, this fresh start, right? Fresh start, like, that's great. I, like, I never looked at it that way, and I've never felt this connected to New Year's as I do now, this time around, this year, 2024. So, anyway, I got this really amazing email offering me something that, and it isn't, just in case you guys are speculating, it isn't the shoot that you guys saw in two vlogs ago, or last vlog. It's not that. It's something different. but it's a big, big, big blessing if I can get it. So I'm gonna send in all the documentation and stuff. I'm gonna get that stuff together tonight. And in fact, I'm gonna start getting some of it together now. Some of it's at home, but I'm gonna get that documentation in. And as soon as I know, I'm gonna tell you. I don't wanna tell you too soon because I don't wanna do that, but okay, I just wanted to check in and let you guys know that it's the second day of the year and things are already looking up. Things are already looking up. My mentality's right. My mindset's feeling good. I'm feeling good in my body. I got the gym. We're going to the gym. You know, yeah, so excited for this year. We're headed out. We're going to the gym to do our walkthrough. So, all right, vlog. All right, vlog. What do I call y'all? Do I call y'all vlog? Do I call you guys friends? I want you guys to leave me a comment and let me know. But we have made it home. I am so sorry. It was not going to happen vlogging in the gym. Unfortunately, there were so many people there working out. It was like, it would have been kind of rude for me to, you guys see this right here? I just burned this morning when I was I put on my vitamin C. Move, Lucy Mae. I put on my vitamin C, but I had a toaster or something in the oven. When I opened the oven and went down, it kind of got hot and it left a mark. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Anyway, I got home from the gym. It was impossible for me to vlog there. There were so many people working out, and the woman who walked me around told me that it was the busiest time because after work, the slowest time is 11 a.m. So I'm going to do that one on my off days, like the slowest time, obviously, and probably try to do classes and stuff. But I am a member. I got my membership badge, and I will use my special code on the back to log into the app. So progress has been made. This has been a great beginning of the year for me. Great beginning of the year. I think that I'm so grateful. And also, because I'm so grateful, I feel like it's just starting to manifest in my life. So, yeah, I'm gonna get in the shower here, do some skincare, and just chill out for the rest of the night. Tomorrow's electrolysis and work too. I'm supposed to have dinner with some friends. I'm on the fence, but I kind of confirmed, which I shouldn't have done, but I did. So I might go. So I might just go. I don't want to spend so much money though, but we'll see. I haven't really hung out with friends a lot, so let's see how that goes. I am home for the evening, and I'm gonna have some dinner, unwind, take a shower, and just chill out. Maybe watch some vlogs or some TV, and just chill. So I will see you all tomorrow. Good night. Good morning. It's the next day. I am up and I am getting ready for work, but I want to stop. I'm doing my makeup. I'm wearing my hair out today. I got to pick it out a bit so it'll be nice and cute, but I wanted to show you guys. So I got a sample from Chanel because Chanel's in the neighborhood where I work now, and they gave me a sample of this Chanel Volume Mascara Primer. Can you see it? Hold on. So it's a sample size primer for your lashes. And if you can see my lashes, they have like the white stuff on it. I've never used a lash primer before. I did not know that you needed one, but what it has done, and you guys see that mark right there, that came from my VIP peel. I have one right here, another one over here, and a couple more under this foundation, but it'll clear up. But anyway, I love this Chanel primer for your lashes so much because I don't have really long lashes. My lashes are really short anyway. And what it actually does is it allows me to see them when I'm putting the mascara on, but also it makes them hard and it makes them stick up. So it gives the appearance of a longer lash. I just thought I'd share that. Okay, all set. Finished look.
The makeup is on. Same lip combo from yesterday. The hair is giving... Man, it's a little too tight for me right now, but it'll definitely, as the day goes on, it'll definitely expand. The outfit is giving, you know, my favorite, turtleneck. The pants are giving those velvet pants that I got from Old Navy. And then the shoes will be some Doc Martens little moccasins. I'll show you. These will be the shoes. Yeah. So that's the look. And we are ready for the day. I got invited to get dinner with a friend who has some friends in town this week. And the dinner is today after work. But I'm having a little work situation too that I'm like so over. So I don't know. I don't know what to do. I had to cancel my appointment for electrolysis today because of all of this. And my electrolysis lady is like very rude, by the way. Also, like, I understand a cancellation policy because, like, I understand the business. And mind you, she didn't have a cancellation policy before. And I canceled once before because something came up. She didn't have a cancellation before. And I canceled and I paid her for the service because I was like, I understand the cancellation policy that much. And it's funny how much influence you have, because I strongly believe that that influenced her to now have a cancellation policy. So she sends me this rude message. And it's like, okay, it's almost like, you know, anyway, I say, hey, sorry, something came up with work, and unfortunately, I need to reschedule my appointment till next week. I'm super sorry for the inconvenience. If I could control it, I would definitely be there. Thanks for understanding. Please let me know what you have available next week. She goes, good morning. Sorry to hear all of this, but I have a cancellation policy, which is 24 hours. And it's the full price of the service. I will excuse you this time, but please know, moving forward, my cancellation policy is firm, even if it's illness. I thought that was so rude. I said, I totally understand, and I will absolutely pay the cancellation policy. You can charge me double next week. No worries at all. She didn't respond. So like 30 minutes go by. And I go, please let me know if you have any available times next Wednesday that works best for me. Thanks in advance. She responds back with this dry message. Hi, Wednesday, January 10th. I have a time available at 9 a.m., 9:30, or 10:15. I go, okay, 10:15 works. She goes, booked. I'm like, girl, that exchange, like, first of all, please know that, like, I need the electrolysis. Like, it's not a thing that I'm just, like, playing with your time. And I've already told you that I'm going to pay the cancellation policy, even though you somehow waived it for me. So can we move forward? And I feel like that's the issue with a lot of things in life that I'm not taking. And I've done this too, to be honest. But I'm not taking that with me in 2024. I'm not bringing that with me now, because it's like, some things are out of your control, and there's really no reason for you to be rude to people. And, you know, granted, we're all human, and we'll have bad days, you know, and I don't know what's going on in her life, you know what I mean? So, for that, I'm giving a little bit of understanding, but at the same time, it's like, this is, well, like, we're exchanging, like, you have a business I'm seeking you for, I'm commissioning you for your business. I'm a paying client I have been a paying client to you. You know me. So I don't understand. And when I canceled for her is once last year after seeing her every week. So I don't know if it's necessary to be rude like that to your clients. And I think that that's what happens in the service industry, especially, I always say New York, but also I think this happens everywhere, but especially in New York. Because there's no, people just do what they think, what they feel. But I definitely think that, like, the service industry people are burnt out. You know what I mean? It's just too up and down, too hot and cold. The economy's changing. People are rude in New York all the time. And so it forces you, and listen, I was a hairstylist before in New York, you know? And I, like, So I understand, like, people are rude. It forces you to have this, like, toughness about it, about yourself. But I'm not there. I'm not there anymore. And I've prayed that off of me because, honestly, it makes you so isolated and just so negative, you know? So, and I've prayed that off of me in my life. And this year, I, like, there's so much happening right now that I'll tell you guys about later with, like, my work that's pissing me off. But I'm moving forward. You know what I mean? I feel like sometimes you just have to move forward. And, like, it doesn't help to take your feelings out on other people. Right? I think we would be better as humans if we just didn't do that. Because, like, I already have something going on that I'm canceling for. I don't want to cancel this appointment. I want to be there for this appointment, girl. I want this hair out of my neck. Do you understand? Like, this is a necessity for me. But I also need for you to understand that there are so many people who do what you do. And I can easily book and go somewhere else and be okay. Do you know what I mean? So I, like, but I'm not going to do that because I understand, like, the independence, and I understand, like, you know, the financial aspect of it, which is why I am choosing to overlook this, but not like be oblivious to the fact that she was super rude and curt to me today, which I don't appreciate. And ultimately, I don't want to do business with people who would treat me that way. So I have the appointment scheduled for next week, and I'm glad to know that there's a 24-hour cancellation policy, because maybe I'll look for someone else. Maybe I'll find someone else and cancel in 24 hours. I don't know. Or maybe I'll go and just, like, see how that goes. I don't know. But I wanted to share that with you guys. Anyway, today is Wednesday, and, you know, I ain't thrilled about it. I ain't thrilled about it. I was usually off on Wednesdays when I'm going to work because, like, the week I push back. I feel like I've been working so much. I'm so burnt out. But I also know that, like, today I had this feeling like I could have stayed home today. I could have been like, you know what, forget it. I'm not doing any of it. But I said to myself, no, I'm not doing that, because here's the thing. I don't want that spirit on me anymore either. I want to be able to get up and move. And, like, and I don't want to get stuck. There's this thing that happens when it's like, oh, just stay. And then what would I have done? Laid in bed for a few hours, went to see the electrolysis, come back, had nothing to do. No, I'm just going to go ahead and go and figure the rest out later. Because it's a new year and blessings are happening. Listen, I am too stressed to be blessed. Scratch that. I am too blessed to be stressed. Blessings are pouring on my life right now. So I got the documents together yesterday. And I'm missing a couple of them that I need to get from, they haven't come through yet, like a work stuff. So, but I have until the 15th to submit everything. So hopefully I'll have those things here in the next few days. But it has to hurry up. So I'll be checking soon. And yeah, happy Wednesday. I will see you guys in a bit. What a day it has been. Honestly, like, I want to scream. But I'm headed to dinner, meeting up with my friend. I remember telling you guys earlier today that I'm having dinner with a friend. I don't think I'm having a full dinner because it's like 8 o'clock. So I will definitely, and their reservations are a little later than I would get there, but luckily the place was like right outside my work. So it isn't really a hassle to get to. So I'm gonna sit, have a drink, wait for the people to get there, schmooze a little bit, but honestly, I kinda just wanna go home. But you know what, it's 2:24, and 24 I'm pushing myself to do more things, and going out after work is something that I haven't necessarily done a lot of in the recent years, but I remember loving it so much before. And I told you guys about, oh my god, look at this cute setup in here. This is why I love Brooklyn. Look at this. Make the world feel something. And then the inside is just like
That can totally be my apartment. So dope. Oh my God, and then there's a secret door. Can you see that? You guys see the secret door? So cute. I love that, it's art. It's in the moment art that I live for. I live for Brooklyn in that way. So the restaurant I'm going to is called Blend. Let me just look it up on my phone to make sure I'm going the right way, but I think it's this way. Uh-oh, why that? Yeah, it looks like I'm going, oh! Almost got hit by a car. Looks like I'm going the right way. Let's see.
Starting walking directions to Blend Williamsburg.
Oh yeah. And I am that girl who needs walking directions.
Feet. The destination is on your left. Okay. Blend Williamsburg.
I'm going the right way. I knew it. Let me just get across here. And in that. Okay. So I also told you guys that I just thought of it because of that gym up there. I was like, that is a gym up there, you guys. I don't know if you can see it, but they're definitely working out. So I kind of thought of it, of the gym from yesterday. There's also a little moment of me being shy with my camera, but why? Color purple. Look at the girls. Look at Miss Seely. Cute. All right, let's get to Blend. I'm excited to see what they have in here. I'll see you guys when we get there. All right, so this is the place. Has a lovely little outside decal. So let's head in. Okay, so Blend was cute or whatever. We had like so many drinks and like even free shots. And you guys are gonna be so shocked to know that people actually gave me a birthday shout out. It was crazy. They had sparklers everywhere. So I'm here with my friends, gang, 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 all the gang. And we're headed to the next spot. So I'll check in with you guys out. Okay, so we're in the Uber and we are headed home from tonight's festivities. It is, hold on, be careful. It is, hold on, let's do this right. 11:08. That is the time that we are usually asleep for sure. And yeah, so tonight was great. But thank you guys for watching tonight. I am headed home. I still have a ton of responsibilities when I get there. The dogs need to be walked, fed, and taken care of. Okay,
We got home. We're out of the Uber. And we showered. We did our skincare. And we're feeling quite refreshed after a long night after work. Lucy Mae. Look at Lucy Mae. She wants to be a center of attention. Say hi to the vlog. Say hi to the vlog. Say hi. Say hi, vlog. We got a package, which we're going to unpack together, obviously. But I do want to show you guys my salad that I'm eating for dinner that I got from Trader Joe's. I already had dinner technically, but I didn't eat much because, as I've told you guys... Oh, by the way, I've had shots and drinks, so your girl is lifted. But I didn't eat that much because I told you guys before about my food thing. I'm super... Hey, give me this. Stop it. I'm like... really specific about food, and also like I just can't eat a lot, so when I'm out, so I'd rather eat at home. So I'm gonna show you a salad that I got from Trader Joe's. Okay, don't mind my hair or the way I look. This is just what it's giving as I'm getting dressed, but I mean, sorry, as I'm getting ready for bed. But let's do the salad. This is the salad bowl that I'm using. Here is not the tea, so it's over here. It's going to be a mess. But this is the salad. I get this from Trader Joe's. Literally, this is a $3, $4 salad. Way better than any $20 salad you're going to buy from a salad shop. I fucking love this black pepper barbecue salad. The name is so much different than it tastes. It doesn't taste anything like black pepper. And it doesn't really taste like barbecue. It's just like a honey... smoky sort of flavor dressing, but it's so good. It's full of kale, cabbage, a bunch of other things, crunchy stuff. I love it. So we'll cut that open just like that. It comes with, this is from Trader Joe's, by the way. It comes with this package, which has like a crunch in it, the dressing, which is there, and then a cheese, which I don't use. And if the, you know, the... if the lighting is off, I'm sorry. But bowl, salad, that simple. That is the salad already mixed. Very simple. This is the dressing. Very simple. And then it comes with a crunch, which I love. And then a black pepper cheese, which I imagine that's the black pepper that I'm missing because I always throw this in the trash. Okay. And that's it. For protein, I like to use these garlic black pepper almonds. And there you have it. A full salad. Black pepper barbecue salad from Trader Joe's. Those are the crunchies. It comes with cabbage and kale. And then I use the almonds for protein. And that's my dinner. So, that's the salad. Do a little taste test for you before I balance. Wow, so tasty. I just want to make sure I get some almonds because protein is very necessary. So, You literally can never go wrong with a salad. It's fresh, it's healthy, it's natural. There is no DNA, it's organic, it's from the earth, and it's great. All right, let's get into this haul. Let me show you what I got from Amazon. I ordered some things from Amazon that I needed the other day. Here's what I got. All right, so I got home hella late and a box was sitting right in front of my door. I did open it, so I'm not gonna act like I did it. I was like, what is it? I kind of forgot, but the box, I opened it, but I didn't open the actual stuff in it. So first of all, this is great for my overall content, although I figured out the volume situation that was happening. I figured it out. Ultimately figured out the volume and the quality at the same time. But I had already ordered this and I'm glad I got it. It's an external mic. It goes on top of my camera. Looks a bit like that. So it has a more of a fuzzier look
than the one that I currently have. The one that I have looks like a dead rat. This one looks a little more fluffy, so I'm excited for it. And also, if it elevates the mic, because I feel like this camera has conditioned me to yell. As you can see, I've been yelling. I want to talk more like this to you guys and maybe give a little cut. You know, I want to give you guys my cut voice like this. But I'm so worried about the sound that I've been talking like this. So, there we go. First thing I got this from Amazon. It was about $30, so not super expensive. And then I also got this Black & Decker duster, which I needed so much for the dogs. I need to like dust my headboard and my couch and everything like that, because unboxing isn't just unboxing it from the delivery box, it's actually unboxing it from the actual box. Vlogger. Yeah, those are the things. So let's get this open. This will be the duster. Now, this is the Black & Decker Dustbuster Advanced Clean. So I'm expecting to get some corners and everything out of that. All right. Comes with a charger. I do have an Amazon affiliate account, which they messaged me about today telling me that I haven't had any traffic there, so they're going to delete it if I don't get traffic there in the next 30 days. So, but I can't figure out how to work it, so it's a whole issue. But this is the charger for the duster. I imagine it has to be put together in some way, which I'm not doing right now, but I know this is, I've used this before, by the way, so okay. So I know that this is the actual piece that sucks up everything. And then this goes down like that if you want to get in corners. And then that, which I'll use on my bed and my headboard to get the dog fur off. And then this is the actual system. Now, I'm sure there is some stuff I need to learn about it before just using it. So obviously I'm not just going to start using it. I will definitely read the pamphlet and yeah, charge it for sure. Black & Decker Dustbuster Advanced Clean Cordless Vacuum. Okay. That's from Amazon, and let me know in the comments if you guys want my Amazon affiliate link, and I will link it. I have to figure out how to do it, but I will link it. But if you let me know in this video, then at least I'll have at least one sale in the next 30 days from one of you or more of you, and that'll keep me active. So that's that. And if not, we'll try again in the future. Like, I'm not pressuring anything. Remember, 2024, it will be what it will be. Period. Carisha. Okay. Microphone. Let's go ahead and get that open. Now, again, this is for my mic now. I cannot wait to elevate my content with this. I guess I gotta start practicing talking like this now so that I don't like start yelling too much, because I think this mic will pick up everything, and I'm already obsessed with it because I just took one little thing and I can already see the cover. Okay, you guys are not gonna understand this because I have to show you the cover I have on my mic now. Okay, big difference. Okay. This on top of my mic is giving, okay, I see you. Hold on, let me get this off. This is up there now. So it's giving faux fur from Forever 21 versus faux fur
from Bloomingdale's or Barney's. Different stories. Completely different stories. So, okay, that's the top to that. I'll put this back on for now just so that it doesn't, like, so that it doesn't ruin the frame or the sound. Get out of my face. Thank you. Thank you so much. And then, where's the microphone? Okay, I don't understand. Where is the mic? Is this the mic? Okay, so I guess it is the, oh, girl, so it's the whole mic. It just has this over top of it. So this is the fur. Oh, this is the actual mic. I was like, where's the mic? This is the mic. So the mic goes into the fur like that. Okay. And this is a piece which I'll have to figure out. This is also a piece which I'll have to figure out. Apparently they both do the same thing. So, don't know, but I will read. Comes with a little baggie, which we love. Everything comes with a bag these days. I remember back in the day when you got a bag with something, it was luxury. But now everything has a bag. So we love that. Accessibility. And then there are two connector cords. So that is my Amazon order for today. Can't wait to get this mic up there. For my birthday content coming up. Guys, my birthday is Sunday. I'm so excited for my birthday this year because I feel more aligned this year than I have in a really long time. So it is definitely a good birthday for many reasons, but mostly just because I feel so aligned with myself. And so many amazing things are happening this year. And 2024 is just my year. I've been praying. My prayers are coming true. And I'm just so amazed at where I am in my life. Who would have knew that I would be living in New York, like, right now? Look at just my lights outside of my window right here. That is also not that grand, but also, like, this is my life. I have to remind myself of that sometimes and remember, this is where I am. So I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I am tipsy right now. Shout out to my friend Mike, who I absolutely am obsessed with. I have to text Mike in the morning or whenever I'm editing this and remember it to let Mike know I love him and I'm so grateful for him. He has this niche of bringing people together. And he does it well, so I want to definitely thank him and let him know that I see you, I see you, I see you. And I'm just also so grateful that I'm one of those people. Because one thing that I am, I learned tonight, I already knew this, but one thing that I was reminded is that I am definitely a table seat person. Like, if you put me at a table, because I was at the end of the table with three people that I had not met before, and Nadira was on my side, who I have met before in Puerto Rico. But our table was lit, and I was like lit, and everyone at the end was like, oh my God, you're such a great, like, it is what it is. So, thanks, Mike. Yeah, I think this is the end of the vlog. Thank you guys so much.